My goal is to mix Dolby Atmos music content in here, and I want to be on the official list of the Dolby Atmos music studios worldwide. And to get on that list, I have to have Dolby in here to measure the room according to their specs. Dolby sent Roger Baltensperger from Zurich, Switzerland. He's a very talented engineer, very sophisticated guy, very knowledgeable. And he also owns a Dolby Atmos home studio in Zurich. And he's working as a freelancer for Dolby, doing all those room calibration, certification things for Dolby. Basically all the jobs that David Ziegler himself cannot do, he is covering for him.
Cool. Wow. Nice. So first we'll unpack everything, we'll set up the microphones. In total we'll have an array of 6 microphones in different positions, so we get a reading of the whole room, because we're not just in stereo, we're in full 3D now. We have the array of all the 6 microphones to do the whole room justice, and we'll have an averaging for every speaker from all 6 microphones in real time, so we can do the adjustments on the merging system, while on the other system with the microphones, we do all the measurements. And we've set the speakers in both in terms of delays and also in terms of frequencies, so we get an exact match with all the Dolby Atmos certified studios around the world. Now we got 2 kinds of microphones here. We got the main microphone, which is an ISEMCON 7150, and then the rest are the Beyer Dynamic MM1s, which is basically the Dolby standard for Atmos Studio measurements. And we have individual files for each microphone, so we know exactly what their frequency response is. The software knows it, so we got a perfectly even and flat measurement from them. And we'll have them face upwards because they are omni microphones. They pick up sound from everywhere, but we don't point them forward, so we don't get like distortions from like the sound pressure levels. We put them up and around the sweet spot, as you'll see later. So we have the microphone set up. We just check the calibration again with our measurement device, and now they're all set, so we can go to the actual measurement. So we will send Dolby calibrated pink noise out of the Dolby Atmos renderer, and we'll check in the smart software here that we're hitting our target curve. So this line here is where we want the speakers, and the green line here is where we want the subwoofer to be. And there will be a lot of noise over the next hour or so when I calibrate each speaker individually and try to match frequency and delay. So in the end, all the speakers should sound the same, because Atmos, we don't think in channels anymore, we mix with so-called objects. So when we move an object around in 3D space, we want it to sound the same anywhere, so it shouldn't sound different when it comes from behind you than when it's in front of you. So we match all the speakers so we can have the objects move around and have them sound the same everywhere. And the goal of the object is that we don't think in channels anymore, but we just think about 3D space. So we put a helicopter up there, we put the wind behind us or a door opening, and then no matter where it gets played back, headphones, soundbar, cinema, the studio, the renderer will decide, okay, it will sound the best when I put it on these speakers. So it can be 64 speakers, it can be 5.1 speakers. And that's why we measure them all the same, so that the object sounds the same no matter where it is in the room. After Roger built up all his microphones, set up his PC and get everything ready, we had a bit of issues with my gear, because I work with audio over IP, so that is all connected to an audio network. And the moment we switched on the Dolby Atmos renderer, which I didn't do before, somehow the whole network didn't really function anymore correctly. So we had to figure out what the problem was.
We have Max from Digital Audio Services in a call right now, and he's also on the Mac with TeamViewer, and we're trying to fix the issue so that we can do the measurement properly without dropouts.
Okay, aber das sieht ja erstmal ganz gut aus. Dann macht doch einfach erstmal weiter. Falls genau. Irgendwas ist, meldet euch.
Reichbar. Super, vielen Dank.
Okay, danke schön, alles Max. Danke, ciao.
Yeah, so we searched a long time, and in the end, it's one simple setting as always. And we just needed to increase the latency for the merging sound card to catch up, because the renderer was also taking some of the performance. So we had to give the merging a bit more room to breathe. And now it's all green, no more red. So I'm happy, and I think we can start the measurements now.
Juhu! Ich mache mir was in die Ohren, einfach weil ich, also es wird nicht so laut, dass es schädlich ist, aber...
We're moving the subwoofer now. So the speakers in the front, we did an initial measurement just to see where we have like our starting point and what we're working with, what we need to correct to get into the Dolby specifications. And with the subwoofer, we saw that there is one specific frequency that is troubling to us. And it's always easier with the subwoofer where we can still move it because it's not tied into a wall or mounted to the ceiling like the other speakers. We're trying to move the sub and see if the problem gets less, because it's always easier to try to correct it this way first. And if nothing else works, we do it in software, but we try to do it first here by physically moving the subwoofer. The subwoofer itself is fine, but of course the subwoofer is only half the equation. The other half is the room. And so-called room modes is basically a certain frequency of sound has the exact length for one wave, like the length of the room or any of the three dimensions of the room. So when it gets reflected back from the wall, it cancels itself out. So basically one wave goes up and the other that comes back from the wall of the same frequency goes down, and then we don't hear it anymore. This gives us a big hole at a certain frequencies. And if, for example, a musical note is right there, you don't hear it in the room, even though the subwoofer is playing it back. So by moving it in the room, we try to minimize the effect of this frequency cancellation. The outcome is good so far. We just tried one other position that I suggested, and we can see there's already 5 dBs less of a problem than we had before. So the big gap that we had is now a lot smaller. We'll try one or two more positions just to make sure if we find an even better one, maybe. And once we settled on a position, we will make the last bit of correction with the digital tools that we have.
As we are finally ready with the studio, and I'm actually operating here and working here on a daily basis, we have now very special guests today. Maurice from Merging, the company I use the audio interface from, and the whole audio over IP technology, and Thomas from Digital Audio Service, who are the distributor in Germany. And they are both here together. They are on a German tour, visiting all their clients, and I'm luckily one of them.
So they visited TV stations and universities, classical music studios, and also me.
Merging Technologies is a Swiss-based company producing and developing software and hardware tools since more than 30 years. And they are used in this very case, for example, to record and to playback audio. So that means that in a gaming situation, for example, when we do Foley, what is called Foley is to do sound effects, for example. So we see just behind me, there are microphones on the floor with objects, is to recreate stupidly, I don't know, somebody that walks on leaves, for example. You're not going to record outside the person who walks on leaves. You're going to create it with some tools and objects with a microphone. So, and once the microphone is connected, you need a converter to be able to make digital audio and a computer to, with a software to be able to record that inside the computer, to make a file out of it. And so we provide everything what is in between the microphone and the computer for the recording. And then we provide everything what is in between the computer for the playback and the loudspeaker. Okay? So that you are able to listen to it, to modify it, to mix it, to transform it, and to adapt it to make it finally an audio file that is a tiny little audio file part of this very big game that somebody plays in his or her living room. So merging technology is providing, I'm just talking about one aspect, but all these professional tools in between the microphone and the loudspeaker.
I also invited Christoph Safferling, who is the Data and Services Director for Ubisoft Germany. He's also overseeing the audio department within the company. And I wanted to just show him the room and welcome him here in my new kind of space.
I'm just here to watch.
He's here to watch, to see the studio. That's all I do. And because we are also planning to build a studio at Ubisoft using the same technology. So therefore, Ubisoft as a company also has an interest to have this working here in my home studio.
And I gave those three a demo. They really liked it. Thomas Röhmann also gave me a bit of feedback, how he felt the whole room and the playback of the scene in a very technical way. But yeah, he's an expert. And you can also read that in my Google reviews on the studio. Christoph was happy. Maurice also was convinced that this room is quite something. Small but sweet. And yeah. One sweet spot and basically highest quality. So now that everything is ready and I have a proper measured Dolby Atmos edit and mixing suite here, I want to be involved in Dolby Atmos music mixing a lot as an engineer myself. And people who want to do that can also rent the studio and come in here and mix their own music. I can support them technically, but the room is for rent as well. Same goes for re-recording linear content. So I can work here as a mixer and mix other people's documentaries, films, short films, advertisement, TV series, stuff like that. And even a cinema movie could be pre-mixed in here. Also, sound designers who want to work in a Dolby Atmos edit suite can come and rent the suite for an X amount of time and finish a complete edit in here if they want. Also possible for me is to work in here as a Foley artist, and I can provide Foley for linear media. Also TV movies, TV series, content like that, I can fully cover in here. These are the things I want to be involved mainly. And if gaming companies want to use this room for their mixes, they can just come here, plug their laptop in or their PC, and we're basically good to go. So my first studio, when I was 18 years old, we had a very different acoustic design. It was just egg cartons on the wall, like the classic cliche maybe. We followed that. I went to a farmer and bought like big boxes with just those egg cartons. And then we put them on the wall, painted them a little bit. And that was the recording room of my first studio.